I saw the first video, the documentary, and now it's watching again and again, like every weekend. Every weekend I'm gonna watch the Freshies Kids documentary because I was too curious about why they start to dance this way. So to me, that was one of my dreams, that I want to go there to see what they are seeing, to eat what they are eating, to feel what they are feeling. They sent me a job that is nowhere. There is a small town that I didn't even know where it is. And the whole city, the whole town, that's CapCut. That is basically, I wake up, I can't see no one. But I quit my job after 1 week of staying there. And me and my backpack were going to New York with $50 in my pocket. I only have $50 in my pocket. I thought everyone is b-boying in New York. So I asked everyone that I met on the street, the random people. I say, do you know where can I find b-boy that I can break with? And then they were like, what is b-boy? And then they don't know what is b-boy. And then sometimes they ask me, so show me b-boy. And then I had to dance on the street to show them. Every day I spend 6 hours to find, looking for a job. And wait until the sunset, I start to look for b-boy spot. Every day I'm looking for this, and 1 week I found nothing. Either the job, either b-boy, I found nothing. Because I saw the Freshies Kids, the documentary, and then I can recognize some streets. And then there's few famous spots from the documentary, like, okay, Rock State Park, okay, like this and that. So I was started looking for those places. I went to Rock State Park like every day to see. But in the beginning, I didn't recognize this Rock City Park because all the graffiti is gone. There's no one b-boying there, but I was sitting there, like spent 2 hours sitting there to watch everyone closely to see if he is in the Freshies Kids documentary. Oh no. So I was looking for, and my girlfriend, she found a picture. There's Crazy Leg. With a sign says Walk of Fame, 159th Street, Rock Steady Crew. All right, and then like this, and I was like, oh, 159th Street, I have to be there, cause their studio must be there. So I was, my girl sent me the picture, and I was asking people, do you know where it is? Do you know where it is? On the street, and then people say, oh, that's in Bronx. So I went Bronx, I took train and went Bronx. So I was walking 155, 156, 150, 161. And there's no 159th Street. Okay, I go backward, and then again, 155 again. And then I started asking people, hey, do you know 159th Street? And then they were like, I have no idea what it is, but I'm telling you, don't talk to black people. And then he left. I was like, what? And then the second guy I asked, he said, hey, dude, don't ever talk to black people, I'm telling you. And then left. I was like, what? And then I went to the cop, the police, asked him for the direction and said, hey, kids, I'm telling you, don't ever talk to black people. I was like, what? Even cops said that? Before I go into the train and going back to where I live, I met, there's like 10 kids, teenagers there. I was like, okay, this is my last chance, I have to ask them. I went to them and then say, if you know the direction of this place. And then they were like, oh, doesn't he Crazy Leg? I was like, oh, you know Crazy Leg? And then they were like, yeah, Crazy Leg is a famous person here, that he's a legendary b-boy. I said, oh, so you know b-boy? And then they say, yeah, but we don't dance b-boy, but b-boy is famous here. You b-boy? I was like, yes, I'm b-boy from Taiwan. I say, oh yeah, so show me. So I was showing them the windmill paddle on the street. And they were like, oh, this guy's for real. And then they started calling their neighbors to come. So they were like, there were like 20, 30 teenagers around me, and I was like break in the middle of the street. But I feel happy and I feel proud because I'm like the guy, I'm like the freshest kiss to them. So I feel happy. In the beginning, I don't have a place to stay because I know no one in Europe. So I stay. Sometimes I stay in a place called Garden House. There's the most scary place I ever stayed in my life. There's a lot of people who in drugs there, and a lot of people they not really psychology normal. I took elevator up to the fourth floor. When the elevator open, the first thing in my eyes is a guy got knocked out, like right in front of me. A guy got knocked out right in front of me, and I was like, okay, so this is the place I have to stay for 3 months. Yeah, I started to think the why I came all the way from Taiwan, and then I couldn't find any, and then I feel suffer. I didn't really dance during me looking for job and b-boys because I was too busy to look for those things. So I didn't really dance. The third time, I finally found that the place, the sign, Walk of Fame, 1593, Brasileiro. And then there's nothing there. There's no studio at all. And then when I asking people, so what it is, the sign. He said it's just Walk of Fame because they are famous. So they have a Walk of Fame right here. So this not as you think, they have a studio there. And the day is the day I only have $1 in my pocket. I change it to quarters and then call my mom. She was like, oh, Jackie, it's you. Say, how are you? And then I heard her voice, I already crying. Like, and then I said, I was crying that I couldn't really control myself. And then I was like, yeah, I'm good. You know what? I'm busy right now. I'm gonna call you back. So I hang up the phone. I couldn't really talk to her because I was crying so much. It's been a month. I don't talk to no one, and I don't hang out with no one. I wake up alone, go to those places alone, come back alone, and no one I talk to. I went to Times Square at the subway station, and I just put my head on the ground and I'm playing the music from my phone. And then I just danced there, even though I couldn't really hear the music. People passing by, nobody watching me. But after 30 minutes of breaking, I feel good because it's like the feeling is familiar. It's like I have no friend, but when I dance, it's like I'm talking to my friend. How I'm suffering during these months, that he's know everything. Even though nobody watching, I put my head, try to make some money, and nobody give me anything. But I ended up with smile. And I didn't notice that there's a girl far away. When I finished, she clapped. She's the only one audience that watching me from the beginning to the end. And then she came to me and then said, she give me the hug first, and then she say you are amazing. And she started to ask my story of why I coming from Taiwan to here. And then she gave me all the money she had. It's all coins. It's like all coins, maybe $1 is not much money. But to me, she is an angel to me. Because she gave me the energy I need for the next day. And then, so the day is the magical day to me. The next day, I found a job. I found the location, the Macquarium Park. There's a lot of b-boy. I heard that there's a lot of b-boy practice there. So I went there, and I see far away there's many, like 40, 50 b-boys practice there, like far away. I was like, whoa, so I run into them, and I drop my backpack, and then I break, like immediately. I saw a flyer, people giving away the flyer on the street, says Rock Steady Anniversary. I go to Rock Steady Anniversary. The first day is the opening party, that's the before party. It's in Rebel Building in Soho. And the party started at 7, and I was there since 6:30. There's no one there, only me. And then in front of security, and I'm waiting for the time count. I want to go in. And 7 o'clock did, and then they start to check IDs. And then the security asked me, okay, so what's your name? I say, Jackie. I say, this is not your name under this. Oh, like, so I have to be under this? I say, yes, it's a private party that you have to be under this. That you can get it. I say, but I wait a long time to find Rock Steady. Finally, I found Rock Steady, but I couldn't get in. That's crazy to me. And then, so they told me they didn't want, not they are not allow me to get in the party. And then I watched everybody going in, and I was sitting on the side. Maybe I from far away watching them go in. I was like really pissed me off. And then 9 o'clock, I watch my watch. 9 o'clock, I go again. Ask the security, and I say, can I go in? I really want to join the party. And then he was like, you still here? You still here since 6:30, and then you still here 9 o'clock. Get in, you know, have fun, you know. So I got in, and then I was like, I see a lot of people wearing Rock Steady shirt. I was like, oh, and then I break.